Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 2015, Distinct Count. All right, all the tips in this book are going to be podcast. Check out this playlist for the whole set. Okay, so today we have to create a report that shows how many customers are in each sector, and a regular pivot table cannot do this. So insert pivot table, we'll put sectors down the left hand side, and then ask for the count of customer, and it says it's giving us the count of customer, but this isn't the count of customer, this is how many records there are. All right, we don't have 563 customers, completely useless, but check this out. Amazingly easy to solve this. Yesterday's podcast we talked about using the data model to join two tables together. Today I just have one table. There's, you know, you wouldn't think there's any reason to use the data model except for this. So choose the box, add this data to the data model. By the way, this is brand new in Excel 2013, so you need 13 or 16. If you're stuck on a Mac or back in Excel 2010, I'll show you the old solution here at the end. Click OK. Build the exact same report, sectors down the left-hand side, count of customer. Exact same wrong answer, but here's the difference. When we come into field settings, see, it looks the same. Sum, count, average, max, min. There's a few missing, and at the very bottom, there's a new one called distinct count. Wow, that is something that has been so hard to do in old versions of Excel. In fact, let me show you how we used to do it in Excel 2010. So here's the data. You would have to come out and do a count if, count how many times vertex 42 appears in column D, and it appears there 6 times. So then the distinct count is equal 1 divided by that. All right, see what we're doing? If there's 6 records with vertex 42, we're giving each of them 1/6 or 0.1667, and when we add all that up, that will get us to 1, right? There's 5 records here, each gets 1/5 or 20%. Add all those up, each of those gets us to 1. So back in Excel 2010 or 7 or 3 or wherever you are, you don't have the data model, so you add those extra fields. There's sector and then distinct count. This was so much more difficult than the new way. So I certainly appreciate the data model for this one. Well, this tip and a lot more are in the book. Click the I in the top right hand corner. You can buy the book. $25 in print, $10 for an ebook. It's cheap. In yesterday's podcast, 2014, we talked about the data model for joining tables. Another benefit is the ability to do a distinct count. Regular pivot table cannot count customers per sector. Add the data to the data model and you have distinct count available. Before Excel 2013, you do 1 divided by count if in the original data. And of course, if you want to do a distinct count for something else, you might have to change that formula. Really, really frustrating. Beautiful, beautiful side benefit of the whole Power Pivot engine.